The question was, what do you do with folks who say all religions are equal? Not one's not any more true than the other. All religions are equal, and all that matters is, are you spiritual, right? Well, here's what you do. This is the way I approach that. I say, do you agree there's a difference between 2 plus 2 equals 4 and 2 plus 2 equals 6? Do you agree there's a difference there? Yes, one's right and one's wrong. Amen? Or at least you got to acknowledge this. They both can't be right. Amen? Put it real simple like that. And then you say this. Islam, you go to the Quran in Surah 5. The Quran says, Jesus Christ is not the Son of God. We go to the Bible. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. They can't both be right. Amen? At least, you know, both could be wrong. Right? Well, no, in that sense, no, one of them's got to be right. Either he is or he isn't. So, you know, the point is, it is absurd to say that faiths that present absolute polar opposites concerning the truth. Hinayana Buddhism says there's no God and there's no Atma, there's no soul, right? We say there is a God and there is a soul. Hindus also believe there's a soul and the Buddhists don't. Well, guess what? They can't both be right. We could go down the list. Judaism denies Jesus Christ as a Messiah. We acknowledge he is. What we have to do is get beyond the nonsense like that, using simple terms, and then what I like to do is turn the discussion to Jesus. Because if you're going to be a serious student of religion, you cannot avoid Jesus Christ. Because think about it. The Hindus acknowledge him as one of the 125,000 avatars, right? Muslims acknowledge him number four of the five great prophets, right? Jews acknowledge that he claimed to be the Messiah. In the Talmud, they even acknowledge he performed miracles, right? They acknowledge him as a historical person. And in Christianity, of course, we claim him to be God. We need to examine this man, Jesus Christ, who changed the world. He's literally the center of time for us in the West, right? You need to examine this guy. And when you do, as C.S. Lewis said it in his great book, Mere Christianity, though I don't agree with the concept of mere Christianity, he makes a lot of great points. And the thing about Jesus Christ is this. From a historical perspective, Jesus Christ really did live. And by the way, the Catechism of the Catholic Church says in paragraph 643, says that the life, death, resurrection of Jesus Christ is a matter of history. It says it is an historical fact. Did you know that? With all due respect to Father Ray Brown, right? Because he was wrong when he said that it's not a historical event. Yes, it is. And the Catechism says so. And the Pope says so. All right, but the point is, why would the Catechism say that? Because, folks, we have more evidence. And get my DVD called Why Be Catholic, because I go through this. We have more evidence of the life, death, resurrection of Jesus Christ than any other event in all of antiquity. In fact, I argue all other events of antiquity combined. It's attested to not just in the Gospels, but by extra-biblical, non-Christian sources. You have, you know, Pliny the Younger, Tacitus, Roman historians, Josephus, a Jewish historian. Suetonius. You have so many different examples of non-Christians. I mentioned the Talmud. Even the Jewish folks who did not believe in him acknowledged that he did miracles. They claimed he did it by the power of the devil, both in the biblical text and in the Talmud. But folks, when you examine the miracles that Jesus did, they can't be explained.